He spent 10 days in jail and paid thousands of dollars in legal fees before the case was eventually dismissed for lack of evidence. He's now suing the police and the city of Woodbridge, New Jersey, for a violation of his civil rights, false imprisonment, and false arrest. Parks is now the third person known to be wrongfully arrested based on faulty facial recognition technology.
I prefer not to have images of my face taken. Facial recognition is typically looked at as a form of artificial intelligence that is able to detect patterns in a face in order to identify a particular individual. There are companies that have amassed gigantic databases of people's face by scanning images on the web. So whenever you put something on Facebook, whenever you put something on Instagram, if you used to use Flickr, right? If you put it on your own blog, there are companies who scan that, add that to their database, and use that to train and operate their system of facial recognition. One place we might see it that where people are very familiar with is the ability to open your iPhone with your face. It softens the ways that it is harmful to society by making it ubiquitous.
We have succumbed to the notion that we should give up our privacy, our anonymity. Your anonymity is such a gift.
To a greater or lesser degree, like, everyone in America is being surveilled. It's a control mechanism.
In certain categories, it is very impactful. Like, not when they're trying to sell you a product, right? But when it's controlling your access to economic opportunity, I think that's very critical. Or when that tracking can lead you to be prosecuted, right? There's a whole criminal justice angle around, how this tracking is being used against us.
One of the effects, or one of the ways that facial recognition is often used, is to track down people who are engaged in lawful behavior.
And so now, instead of going about my business on a walk or a run or whatever, I'm actually being surveilled by every single house. Who are the people who are gonna be heavily policed?
Anti-Black racism is built into the notion of surveillance. The ways that anti-Blackness and surveillance are linked are run back far in our history, as long as the history of this country. Let's think about that in terms of predicting who's going to be a criminal, deciding who should get a job, who gets a mortgage. Let's think about that in terms of deciding who has their children taken away by the state.
When you're in a position where your identity itself is persecuted, then of course you should value your privacy and think about it very, very carefully. There is research that shows that Black women are recognized with higher error rate. But what happens is not that you don't get identified. What happens is you get misidentified as someone else. So to me, building technology to perpetuate that type of carceral system is very dangerous.
Imperfect surveillance is bad, but perfect surveillance is worse.
I don't think we're too late. I think we are late, absolutely, but I believe in the tech industry to be able to adapt to new rules and new regulations. They can recode, reprogram what they need to work within a fairer, more equitable framework around AI regulation. And I think society will be better for it.
Think about the narratives that are put forward by these companies and what those narratives entail. If I have a package that I am expecting and I can't be there, I talk to my neighbor and ask them to look out for it. That makes better neighbors. Streetlights make better neighbors. People feeling safe and secure makes better neighbors.
What we really need is regulation. We need regulation with input from the public, with elected officials by the public to have checks and balances on the use of not just corporations, actually, you have law enforcement and the government itself using some of the technology without really the public understanding the repercussions.